Focus. Was it not necessary that the Messiah should suffer these things and then enter into his glory? Luke 24:26. The natural reaction to suffering is to run away from it and take refuge in various things, like addictions, bad relationships, soothsaying, or other feel-good factors. Having lost all hope, the disciples in today's gospel sought to make their escape to another town. They were so dejected that they could not even recognize the hope that Jesus was offering them by his very presence. Suffering can and does seem like a monster that raises its ugly head time and again to destroy us. However, Jesus looks at suffering as a means to enter glory, to be able to endure the storms of life and emerge as a better and more graceful person requires us to cooperate with God's grace, which is freely available to us. Consoled by Jesus, the two disciples returned to Jerusalem with joy and courage. As messengers of the resurrection of Christ, they were able to comfort the apostles and many others. Eventually, the apostles went forth to spread the message of Christ to all. We see Peter and John so filled with hope and faith that they are able to do mighty miracles. The joy that God offers in the midst of pain, confusion, and darkness has a ripple effect. Fruit. By choosing to see suffering through God's eyes, I can be an agent of hope and peace.